Vegas massacre investigation is over after FBI's shocking sudden announcement. There's been very little recent talks about the massive shooting in Las Vegas. Not much has been discussed about Stephen Paddock. We don't know the motive. We don't know if he had accomplices. We don't really know much of anything, and it looks like we're not going to. According to one source, the FBI is shutting it down. It's suggested that the FBI will not release any further information on the grounds that it simply does not matter and no further evidence from the Las Vegas massacre is necessary to be released to the public. The narrowly available evidence is thin enough. All we know is that a man with a lot of guns shot a lot of people from a hotel window. That's literally all we know about the shooter, and we don't have much information in regard to his motive or anything else. There are theories that he was radicalized by ISIS, and ISIS may have claimed it, but where's the evidence? We have a missing hard drive, and his brother was accused of having some sick content on his computer, but what else is there? Your Newswire posted this information, which they retrieved from a different website source that is available on their page. The silence from authorities has gotten so obvious that even local mainstream news outlets are sounding the alarm. When you couple this with the documented evidence that points to both the LVMP and the FBI lying directly to the American people, you have all the hallmarks of a classic false flat terror operation. 58 people killed. More than 500 injured. And yet, nearly a month after the Las Vegas Strip experienced the worst mass shooting in modern American history, local and federal authorities are refusing to fill in the blanks, the Las Vegas Review-Journal reported. It wasn't always like this. In the days after October 1, when Stephen Paddock opened fire on the Route 91 Harvest Festival crowd from his Mandalay Bay Corner suite, Las Vegas police were hosting multiple news conferences a day. Then, once a day. Then, once every few days. The above paragraph is striking in that it openly admits that at first authorities were quick to deliver their message, attempting to lock in the official narrative surrounding the worst mass shooting in American history. Only after independent investigators began to tear apart the official narrative did authorities all of a sudden decide they need to be cautious about what they put out, eventually moving to where we are now with literally no new information being released. The Review-Journal goes on to note that by October 13, when the alternative media had broken the story wide open, the sheriff had changed his manner completely, going from a seemingly straightforward and stern speaker to now emotional and combative. Keep in mind this was right around the time that outlets like the Daily Sheeple and IntelliHub, as well as independent reporters like Laura Loomer, were publishing explosive reports that proved that the sheriff and his FBI handlers were indeed lying to the American people. If we go by what your Newswire suggests, then it appears like the authorities were slowly turning silent and not speaking much with the media or public in regards to releasing information on the massacre. The website suggests that law enforcement was lying to the public, but you have to wonder if they were informed to remain quiet or did so because there was actually just no further information to be had. Law enforcement won't have much to say if there's nothing to talk about, right? It is entirely possible that they simply don't have any other information. Therefore, they would obviously be quiet because there's nothing to say. It's also possible that forces well and above their realm of power have put a be quiet order on things and they're just following orders. Everything is open for discussion in regards to theoretical possibilities. There's plenty of answers that people are looking for and they just can't find the answers. The lack of information is what's driving people to conjure numerous conspiracy theories about the Las Vegas massacre, and the truth is that we just don't have the answers. Does someone have the answers? Maybe. We won't ever know unless someone finds some legitimate evidence to support any claims they're making. Conspiracy theories are fun, but they have to be taken with a grain of salt. We need to be sure we're not following a trend that leads us down a wrong path and we end up looking silly to our cohorts. On the contrary, some conspiracy theories could be turned into facts if someone would find real evidence to back up their claims. We need to be diligent in backing up our claims with facts and truth. We simply cannot follow the sheep, but we also can't be that stray sheep that's talking up a bunch of crazy things and wearing a tin hat. Stay somewhere in the middle and be open-minded to all possibilities. While theorists are out there hunting the truth and seeking deeply hidden or non-existent information, I'll be over here eating some leftover pineapple pizza. Just kidding, pineapple on pizza should be illegal. Legal.